Ever found yourself waiting for a reply on WhatsApp? There's no question you've encountered the dreaded blue tick. It provides a kind of a paradox. While it keeps you informed, it also makes you extremely anxious. And this is not unintentional. Coupled with the last scene, the blue tick might take you down a road of endless questioning and conspiracy propagation. If you ask the fundamental question of technology, that is it supposed to make us feel more convenient or is it supposed to make us feel more productive? The answer is yes, it's both. There is no separating what we do for convenience and as a result, what we end up doing for productivity. While computers and software have influenced productivity in several industries, Facebook and Instagram are known to make your life more miserable, yet they keep adding more cues to keep you addicted to it, but for advertising profit. This is function tied to the psychological cue that people don't want you to see. Back to WhatsApp. If you turn off the blue tick and last seen in your preferences, it means no one else can see your last seen or blue tick either, which might draw more conspiracies about what you're doing on WhatsApp. Instagram recently brought back active status, a tiny green dot that's the remnant of the 90s internet. It drew a lot of flack for doing this because it's a contradiction towards their recent initiatives to ensuring that your time is well spent on Facebook and Instagram. This shows that when billions of dollars are on the table, it's not an easy decision to choose what's best. Albert Einstein once said, "We can't solve problems using the same kind of thinking we use to create them." And this strikes at the heart of what people are trying to do with technology once again. They feel like it is the solution to the problem, while the answer might just be to switch off or to be more aware every single time we use the internet.
We're making the world a better place through Paxos algorithms for consensus protocols.
And we're making the world a better place through software-defined data centers for cloud computing.
A better place through canonical data models to communicate between endpoints.
A better place through scalable, fault-tolerant, distributed databases with ACID transactions.
We're giving back something very important in return when we choose convenience. Our increasing ambivalence to how the internet is designed.
Remember when you used to get spam with all those LinkedIn invites from friends? Well, that was because of a confusing dark pattern on their ad contacts page, which allowed LinkedIn to scoop up people's email contacts and send them messages repeatedly without their consent. In a comprehensive blog post, Dan Schlosser showed how LinkedIn tried to trick users 8 times in their sign-up and onboarding procedures into surrendering their email contacts.
I recently installed iOS 12 on my phone, and there's a new feature which shows me how much time I've spent on each app.
Every week, you get a weekly activity summary that details how you used your iPhone or iPad. You can make decisions about how much time you want to spend with your device each day.
I would have never guessed this, but WhatsApp is my most used app. It becomes very difficult when you're in a habit to ask yourself to get out of it. But this is my plea to you. Ask yourself with intention, what do you want your internet experience to be? As more and more of us get involved with not just consuming, but creating for the internet, we need to design experiences for other people with empathy and respect in mind. And we can only do that once we have it for ourselves.